Hello there, and thank you very much for joining us today in this new Azure Portal How-To video. Today, we'll learn about Azure Portal Service Information Cards, and we have Balbir Singh with us, who is going to show us all about these new cards. So thank you very much for joining us today, Balbir.
Leon, thanks for having me. Let's jump right into this demo. On the homepage, we've introduced a new service card that will appear after a short delay when you hover over any one of our services. In this example, I'm hovering over our virtual machines, and you'll notice that the card will appear and have a secondary reveal that will show you more information. Our goal with this card was to provide you with all the relevant information in front of you, and very specific to the resource that you're on. Let's start off on the top of the card. You'll notice that we put some very common buttons right at the top. Being able to create and browse all of your resources are the most common commands that users want to be able to do.
So basically what I can do here is I can create a new virtual machine, or I can go through the list of virtual machines that I already created.
Exactly. And right below that, we've offered recent resources, a section on training, another one for useful links, and then on free offerings.
And how does these recent resources work? Like basically when I access a VM, it's going to show up here?
Precisely. Anytime you interact with any one of your VMs, we're going to store that information and we're going to populate the most recent items in this list.
And I don't have to do anything, right? It just happens automatically.
It happens automatically. We've also curated a very specific set of documentation that's relevant to virtual machines. We want you to be able to learn about the service, understand the best ways, what are the best practices, and help you get started.
And I see the free training, that's Microsoft Learn, is that
it
right?
It is Microsoft Learn.
And how about the useful links?
Useful links, this is a great spot for users that are new to the portal. To understand, give you a quick overview of the service, help you get started, and then, of course, the most important, pricing.
That's great.
We also provided free offerings. Of course, as a new user, we want you to take advantage of some of these free offerings.
Great, and this is for a virtual machine, but what happens for sets, for example, for a resource group?
Great question. Let's take a look at what happens when I hover over my resource group. Again, the same sort of commands, the same sort of sections, but obviously we're going to populate the recent resources with the most recent resource groups that you just interacted with. So again, we're putting the most relevant information front and center and at your fingertips.
So it's service specific, basically.
Precisely.
And what is, for example, a resource that is non-specific at all, like all resources? What would happen in that case?
Great, another great question. By hovering over all resources, you'll notice that these are all the resources that I've interacted. Again, it's that sort of recent list of things that I've interacted with at the top of my list.
Oh, great. So basically, it's not resource specific, but you're showing me the recent things of different types, basically.
Exactly. Now, you might be wondering, what happens if I've never interacted with any of these resources? For example, in storage account, I've never deployed a storage account, and so I don't have recent resources. And this is where I want to provide you with a description. You know, if you're not familiar with storage accounts, this is a great way for you to learn about it and understand what's included.
And that's great, because I can read the description, and then if I want to, I can decide to create an instance. So I have the create button right there.
Exactly.
Great.
The great thing is that we provided these service cards in several locations within the portal. Let's take a look at another spot. By clicking on all services, similar view, by hovering over any one of the services, the hover card will reveal after a short delay and then fully extend to provide you all that content. Another place that we also offer service cards is on the favorites bar. As you can see, by hovering over any one of the items on the service bar, on the favorites bar, sorry, you'll notice that the hover card appears as well.
Oh, that's really nice.
Same relevant information. One other thing I should call out, you'll notice that on the hover card, there is a star located in the top right-hand corner. This will allow you to pin this specific service to the favorites bar. Let's take a look at that. And you'll notice that the app services is now visible in the favorites bar.
So by clicking the star, you added that service to your favorites list.
Precisely. And similarly, if you wanted to remove it, by unselecting the star, the service is removed.
Let's click back on the bar and let's see it.
Oops, I did not click on it.
Oh, let's do it now.
Oops. There we go.
It's gone.
It's gone.
Great. So thank you very much, Balbir. So basically, with the service information cards, we show them in the homepage, in the list of all services, and in the favorites bar. And what we give customers is the access to the most common actions and relevant information so they can accelerate their workflows in the portal.
Exactly.
Thank you very much.
Thanks for having me.
And thanks every one of you for watching. Please try this out and let us know what you think. Leave us a comment in the comment section, follow us on Twitter, and look forward to seeing you in the next video. Thanks for watching.